Yet I am to worship, yet I am to honor. I have only a short message today. It won't take us more than 20 minutes and I am gone.
You are worthy, Jesus, worthy. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy, Jesus, you are worthy. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to your name, Father. Glory be to your name, Jesus. We worship you, Father. We give you glory, Lord. We adore your majesty, Lord. Hallelujah to your name. Thank you, Father. Glory, honor, power, majesty, belong to thee, our God. Glory, honor, power, glory. Father, ancient of days, the lily of the valley, the bright of morning star, we worship you. Our Father, our King, our Lord, our Savior, our friend, our Prince of Peace, the ancient of days, we worship you. Rock of ages, we praise your name. The Lord, I am that I am, I am that I am, we thank you, Jesus. The Lord that breaks, the Lord that molds, the Lord that builds, the Lord that destroys, the Lord that constructs, the Lord that have powers in all powers. The greater than the greatest, the mightier than the mightiest, the most wonderful Father, the King of Kings, the righteous and holy God, the I am that I am, the everlasting Father, the one that built the heaven and the earth. He makes the heaven and he put the tent of heaven, and nobody knows the hedges, nobody sees the pool, nobody sees the stretches, and it spread all over the world with your wisdom, with your majesty, with your greatness. We worship you, Lord. You worship you, Lord. You created man in your image. You enrich the heart with your blessings, and the treasures of knowledge the heart will bless you, Father. You provide breath into the heart and life of those that you have created will worship you. The creation of man is mysterious. The living of man is mysterious. The death of man is mysterious. The birth of man is mysterious. The power of God is mysterious. You are the mighty and wonderful and great and great and great and great and great and the greatest King Father. We worship you, Lord. 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 We give you all glory and adoration and praise. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
When I read the goodness of the Lord Jesus, I cannot just thank him enough. He will bring us from all the dirty pit of life, and he will make us to be seated with the King of the world, and will wash away all our sins and iniquity, and will place us to be his servants. Even the people that are not worthy to be anything next to God, the Lord will bring us into his righteousness. For his name's sake, we give glory to his name. It is because of the mercy of the Lord somebody like even me can hold microphone and speak about God and serve him. The Lord has brought me far from the dungeons of life and he placed me on the hills of his place, his hiding place. I worship the Lord. Hallelujah to your name, Father. We praise you. We give you glory. We adore you, Father. When I remember what the Lord has done, I will never go back anymore. When I remember what the Lord has done, I will never go back anymore. No, 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 no. That is what we are going to sing again. Amen. Sub yourself, submit to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Lament and mourn and weep, and let your laughter be turned to mourning and your joy to gloom. Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he will lift you up. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I thank God for always giving us one thing, no matter how big and small, but we are always blessed with it every day. Like I said, I did not have any. When the Lord has not given message, I believe he just wants us to praise him and go home. Amen.
Amen.
But as we're praising him, he just wants us to maybe have this small thing to go home with. Therefore, you must submit to God and resist the devil, and we bring you, as I was thinking about this Bible passage, and I was saying, submit to the Lord and resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Without submission to God, we cannot resist the devil. That was the conclusion I draw from there. If there is no submission, there is no resistance of the devil. Have you been troubled with addiction or some other things, problems of life? Or you are the one that are struggling with putting enemy to his position for the rest of your life? You are tired of victory today and trouble tomorrow. You are tired of constantly battling with night attacks and nightmares. So the word of the Lord that I have to read for you today is, submit yourself to God and resist the devil. And I will explain further a little bit for the short time that I said. Submit yourself to God. If devil knows those people that are submissive, those people that are humble, and those people that are obedient. Without obedience, submission, humility, nobody can ask the devil to be the devil to flee. If we do not submit ourselves into obedience, if we don't submit ourselves to humility, and we don't submit ourselves to God in total leadership, we will not be able to resist the devil. Submission. What does submission mean? I was beginning to think. Submission. What can that mean? Submission is to surrender your total self to the leadership of another. Total surrendering of yourself to the leadership of another. But in this case, it says submit yourself to God. When we are talking about submission, you do not have say anymore. When the Bible says, wife, submit yourself to your husband, what does that mean? Which means is the owner, is the head of the house. He becomes the driver of the bus. If there is two in our book of in our study during the fasting period, if there is two captain on the ship, what happened? The ship will have trouble because everybody have different opinion. This is where we go. This is where we go. So when you are submissive, when you are submitted to God, you don't have a say anymore. We begin to understand now. So to overcome, the only way to overcome devil and his agents, witches or wizards permanently, completely, or to get out of the situation we don't like, is submission. If you are not submitted to God, you cannot get out of any situation. You cannot even get out of sin to start with. You cannot get out of any permanent trouble that has been troubling your life. Submission, any part of the body that is not submitted to God is not free. If your leg is not submitted to God, it's not safe. If your hands are not submitted to God, they are not safe. If your head is not submitted to God, that is trouble. Because the head you can replace any part of the body, but you cannot replace your head. Head cannot be replaced. If people that lost their legs in war, in Syria and other places where they are fighting, well, you see they have artificial legs. If you lost the hand, you have artificial hand. You can lose any part, but if you lose head, there's no artificial head. I don't know if anybody has seen one. Artificial head, there is nothing like that. People can lose their hide, they put artificial hide. They will be seen like any other, but the head is more important. The Bible says, and when you are submitting, your head is needed. If I want to say I want to bow to somebody now, which means submission of respect, my head has to go down, isn't it? So if your head is not submitted, there cannot be permanent victory. So the short message that I have today is called submission to God. To have permanent victory over the devil and his agent, we must totally submit ourselves to God. I will read again from another Bible passage. I'll put finger in this one and go quickly to the book of Romans chapter 6 verse 19. If you are there, you can read it. Romans 6, 19.
Romans 6, 19 says, I speak after the manner of men, because of the infirmity of your flesh. For as ye have yielded your members, servants to uncleanness and to iniquity, unto iniquity, even so now yield your members, servants to righteousness, unto holiness.
Verse 16.
Romans 6, 16.
Yes, ma'am.
Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourselves servants to obey, his servants ye are to whom ye obey, whether of sin unto death or of obedience unto righteousness.
Amen. It says, whosoever you submit yourself to obey, you are that person's what? Slave. If you submit yourself to obey God, to righteousness, or to sin, to the devil. Amen.
Amen.
Submission. If you still, which means if you still begin to see yourself committing sin or living in sin, you are submitted to the devil. You are submitted to sin unto the devil. And that's the reason why the devil claims many people's lives, say they are my servant. And yet the people might say, I'm a child of God. People say, I'm a child of God, and the devil says, they are mine. I remember I was reading maybe on the internet somewhere about one of the sisters that God gave revelation. And the sister said he was taken to a place, and in that place, devil was there. And some people that still use those worldly things, devil always claimed that they belong to him. So she was there too. That was the sister that said she was become disobedient to her parents when she got to America, and she lost her senses. And that was taken out of her living rooms. Yeah. So she said, even the devil was trying to claim her. If not because it was not her time to go, she would have gone to hell. She was saying that she belonged to God on heart. She was saying that she's a child of God on heart. But indirectly, the devil was claiming ownership of her. She said, if not because Jesus stopped the devil was coming to reach for her. Say, you too, you are mine. And what happened to her? She was fervent, dedicated child of God. And as soon as she got to America, she was going back bit by bit. Many of our African children of God, they were very fervent when they were in Africa. They were on fire, men and women. They loved the Lord. In fact, some of them have power and fire in them more than their pastors. Even there are some even pastors in Africa, born again, dedicated pastor, as soon as they got abroad to bring gospel abroad, as soon as they start traveling to the Western world, they obtain their visa. You see everything about them, you just begin to collapse. Collapse that I'm talking about is not that collapsing financially or anything, but the gospel of Christ in their life will be collapsing. The submission will be going away slowly. The commitment to God will be disappearing suddenly. I used to tell people close to me that if you are a child of God and you cannot hear the voice of God anymore, God does not speak to you anymore. For 1 month you have not heard anything from God. No revelation, No Bible passage, no anything. You just live and live throughout the whole year. You need to go and do another 21-day retreat for yourself. Maybe there's a trouble somewhere. Because it is not common that God will not speak to his children. And to remember that Romans 6 verse 16, anyone you submit yourself to obey, you become that person's servant. To God, you submit to God, you live unto righteousness, isn't it? You submit to sin, you live unto what? The fulfillment of the activity of the devil. Amen. It is very clear to know who you are living for. If you live to edify the Christ, to work for him, to serve him, to obey him, then you are looking, living for Christ. But if you see yourself behaving in another way, not being able to live without sin, then you are not submissive or submitted to God yet. And the Bible says you must be submitted to God before you can resist the devil. Nobody on earth has power over the devil. I am saying this not because I'm afraid of him or witch or anything, but I'm saying it, that's the way it is. We don't have our power over the devil or the witch or anybody, but we have power because we are submitted to God through the Lord Jesus Christ. So your submission to Jesus gives you supernatural power over the power of darkness. Your submission to Jesus gives you power to speak against nature. So the more submitted you are to Christ, the more power you have spiritually. The more submitted you have to Christ, the more power you have spiritually. And the more power you have over nature, everything that the Lord has created. Amen. Because when the Lord created what? The heaven and earth and all the things in the world. Genesis chapter 1 verse 26. Can somebody read quick? Genesis 1, 26. We still put our finger in that. James 4. Genesis 1, 26. 25, 26. Quickly.
And God made the beast of the head after his kind, and cattle after their kind, and everything that creepeth upon the head after his kind. And God saw that it was good. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the head, over the cattle, over all on the earth, over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth.
Amen. You see, when God finished creation, he finished all the creation, then he made a man. And when he made a man, that he made last, and he now said, let man take dominion over everything, every what? Everything in the heart, including the beast, including the poisonous animal. Something happened to me sometimes ago when I was still young, when my parents decided I should go to village to go and learn village experience. You know when you become troublesome in city, they just send you home to say it's because you have not been punished so much. Just like some children in Europe here, some parents send them to Africa to go and spend like 2 years in secondary school there. So that they can learn. There was a time I threatened my son there, Junior, I said, maybe you go to Africa for 2 years. And you come back here, you become the wisest of the wise when you come back here. By the time you drink Gary in the afternoon and in the hot sun, you look for Gary water without sugar and granite. Then when you come back here, when you come back to Europe, your head will calm down very well. And when they even mention Africa, when you hear AF, you just take over. Because you know that it's not. So I was in the village. I was learning the village experience. So one day we went to look for, I was on the farm. And it is the, you know, custom of the rats or rabbits. When you are looking for them, the big rat, they can go, they will go into the hole. So, mouse. So we were pursuing mouse and it went to the hole. So I was using cutlass to dig the hole. And another person was waiting with a stick. So that when the mouse comes out, you just hit the mouse with a stick. So I was digging. The hole was so small. But I don't know, you know, mouse, they can manage the stretch and go inside. So I was digging and I was putting my hand to remove the sand. I will put my hand to remove the sand. and I would dig. I would put my hand to remove the sand. So as I put my finger, I just felt something. Then I removed my hand. I saw something like blade cut. And water was coming out and blood. I said, what is this? Then as I was looking at it, I was feeling some poison going around my finger from here. So the more I looked, this place was becoming stiff and no blood inside. My hand was going bit by bit without blood. I didn't feel blood anymore here in my palm, from the finger to my palm. Then I screamed. The next boy to me knew what, because I was a town boy that they brought to village. So the next boy knew what happened. He said, that's a poison. So we don't know what yet that just stung you, but you have just been stung by a poisonous thing, maybe snake or scorpion or something. So he quickly looked for a palm leaf and he tied the this side. By the time he came back with the palm leaf, my hand, he was going over to this place. So he quickly tied, he said, where do you feel the pain? I said, I can't feel anything up to here. Then he quickly tied this around my elbow. And he said, I should wait there. I said, this thing is paining me, but it tied so tight that the thing couldn't go up anymore. He just said, we need to find that word first, because he has been in village for a long time. Because we will not know how to deal with it if we don't know what it is. I said, okay, please do quick. Yeah, yeah. I put the hand on my head. It now became very, very painful. Yeah, 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 please. So he said, oh my God, it's a scorpion. And the scorpion was big, huge scorpion. And he killed the scorpion. He said, let's go home. So I began to run. I was running. He was following me. So when I got to my grandfather's place, I just fell down on the floor. By the time I fell down there, it was already somewhere here. All my hands to my armpit, from finger to my armpit, everything sore and painful, and was swollen. I said, you people, who asked you to go to that place? I didn't even tell anybody I was going to that farm. We just went hunting. We went hunting for animal, not even to the farm. So then there was a policeman. That's where I'm going. There was a policeman. My grandfather, that's my mother's father, that time used to sell beer. So in the beer parlor there, that's where I ran to in the village. So the policeman was drinking beer there. And the policeman, ordinary human being, he just stood up. He said, bring it. He took my finger. He said, can I have onion? My grandmother, my mom's mom, ran quickly to kitchen, brought onion. Then he chopped small part of the onion, he put in his mouth, he mashed and spit it into his palm, and he began to speak. He began to speak incantations. Then he said, bring your finger. He said, where is the pain now? Where has the pain reached? I said, my armpit. Then he was rubbing from my armpit down to my finger. He said, now come out. He said, come out. Come out. Do you know, as he was saying come out, water and blood was dropping and the poison dropped and everything vanished immediately. All the pain from my armpit to the finger went immediately, not later. That is human being, police. A policeman that everybody said this one is a police, Nigerian police. African police. You see, human being have authority over snake. Human being, through demonic means, through incantation of the demon, of the devil. How much more you, human being? That is one thing that are giving me. I am not bragging about it. I am not proud about it. That is one reason. I have seen many things in my life. Demonic, Islamic, those things have given me courage to operate the measure that I'm operating now. Human being that did not know the supreme God that I serve could speak to poison of snake or a scorpion to come out, I will be able to do that with God. That is my belief. So since the day I believe that, anything I spoke to, I used to believe in my heart that they have to listen to me. If demonic person can speak in the name of demon, incantation of the devil, to bring poison out of my hand, then I learned a lesson from there. I should be able to pray to God and speak incantation of the Bible and bring the thing out. Because the Bible says the Lord has given us power over scorpion and what? Serpent. And that is where I realized the reason why The snake beat Peter, isn't it? Is it Peter or Paul?
Paul.
A snake beat Paul and the snake died instead of Paul. Because he crossed his band. He was not supposed to touch that one. Because Jesus, God is powerful. Even God is his word in the Bible is applicable to snake and animal. When he says, haven't you heard? Touch not my anointing and do my ministry. He even addressed that to animal too. Don't you know that Paul is my anointed? And you go and bite him, you are done for. And the snake died instead of Paul. Every human being, every beast, they understand the promise of God for your life. Deuteronomy chapter 30 verse 19. Can somebody read it quickly?
What? Deuteronomy 30:19.
Yes.
I call heaven and earth. To record this day.
Against you.
That I have set before you. Life and death.
Blessing and cursing.
Therefore.
Choose life.
That both you. And thy seed.
And your children.
May live.
You see. When the Lord created everything, he called everybody to reckon. Snake, poison, lion, tiger, all the dangerous animals and things, including witches and wizards and the devil, to bear witness that if these creations, all these people that I created, if any of them will choose life in me, through my son Jesus Christ, they must live. And anyone that go against that, they will do what? They will be punished. Anyone that go against somebody that choose to lose, if you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, that's the first stage of submission. Don't forget that, James. Submit yourself to the Lord, and you'll be able to resist the devil. Once you give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, you have chosen life. Then you are left with submission. So when you choose life, the old things, everything that God created must know that you are no longer an ordinary human being. I used to say something that it looked like a bragging word, that only my wife is familiar to it. I would say, I am not an ordinary person. Do you remember that? I used to tell my wife, I'm not an ordinary person. But it looked like bragging. But it's not. I'm not bragging in the flesh, but I'm bragging with God in the spirit. I am not an ordinary person, because I am a child of God. Joshua 1:18, quickly. Joshua chapter 1 verse 18.
Joshua 1:18. Whosoever he be.
Whosoever.
That doth rebel.
Now, this is what I used to pray. I remember one of my sister asked me one day, this prayer point, do you see, when you say whosoever, is it not praying against somebody? Now, I just want to show us quickly today. Is it me that I say that in this Bible passage?
No.
Is it my own word?
No.
Can we read it again? 18.
Whosoever.
Can we read it together, everybody? Want to go?
Okay,
let my sister read it then. Since it became, this is now, it has become a battle. Civil war. Oh yeah, really, don't overthrow me in the church. Yeah.
Joshua 1:18.
Yes.
Whosoever he be. That rebels. Against thy commandments.
Against your commandments.
That will not hearken.
That will not yield.
Unto thy word.
Unto your word.
In all that thou commandest.
In all that you commanded him.
He shall be put to death. Only be strong. And of good courage.
Amen. Am I the one that said that?
No.
Anyone that, if you want to rebel against the word of God, that is your business. All I know is that I pray whosoever, anybody. So if somebody now put their head to anybody, it becomes what? Naden Sabi. Our African people say that, Naden Sabi. Amen. So we have covenant. Once we submit to God, you are a covenanted child of God. All the problem, all you need to do is submission. Submit unto God. And I will close on that area. Like I said, I won't take us time. I just want to emphasize on submission. We have seen the promises that we can get from submission now. Victory. Answer to prayer. And if you hear a man of God come before you and say, ah! They bring a, maybe somebody that is behaving funny, a mad person. A mad person that, and is coming, and you say, leave him, leave him. Ah! In the name of Jesus. And the person just falls down or just begin to manifest. That is what caused it. It's not any anointing. I used to say to people, not there is anointing. I'm not disputing that, but nobody carry anything on the body apart from submission. The level of submission is the level of manifestation of the power of God in your life. Amen. So your submission produces obedience of the power of darkness. If you are not submitted, they cannot obey. I will confirm another Bible passage before I round up now. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, I believe. 1 Corinthians 10. 1 Corinthians chapter 10. Still looking for it, I'm coming. Sorry, 2 Corinthians 10, verse 6. Yes, ma'am.
2 Corinthians 10, verse 6.
Yes.
And having in readiness to revenge all disobedience when your obedience is fulfilled.
Amen. So you'll be able to bring other powers onto subjection, onto obedience of your word. When your own obedience is what?
Incomplete.
So part of submission is obedience. Part of submission is what?
Obedience.
Obedience. When you do not obey the word of God, before God declared that to Joshua, in that Joshua chapter 1, verse 8, can you read it? He declared that to Joshua in 18, but in 8, he said something to him.
Joshua 1:8.
Yes.
This book of law shall not depart out of thy mouth.
Shall not depart from your mouth.
But thou shalt meditate therein day and night.
Yes.
That thou mayest observe to do according to all that
you must obey everything that is written in the Bible.
For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous.
You will make your way prosperous.
And then thou shalt have good success.
You see, before he said that in 18, he said you must obey. So obedience is number one stage of submission. Anyone you submit to, you obey. When the Bible says submit to your husband, it means obey your husband. So when you say I'm submitted to God, you are not living in obedience, you are not submitted. When we are submitted to God, we are living in a rebellion, we are not submitted. And therefore we cannot get evil spirit to obey us. Our sister was talking today through baby prayer or Sunday school, I can't remember, he said, a man of God said, somebody that was possessed casting out another possessed person. It's not that the person was possessed. It's because the person was disobedient. When you are disobedient, you are casting evil spirit out, they will cast you out. The right language to you is that a disobedient child of God casting out evil spirit from somebody. So it will look like the person to have evil spirit. Because any disobedient is a spirit. And that disobedient you need to be casted out before you cast another spirit out. Otherwise, the spirit will just ridicule the person. So disobedience to the word of God is not submission. So when we submit, that policeman was living under submission of evil powers. They must have done plenty of charm for him to go to police force. So that was part of the thing, that anything he declared with his mouth, with this incantation to any poisonous thing or bullet, they have to come out. And living in submission to them. And when you are submitted to the evil spirit, part of it is that you have to give regular sacrifices to them. Maybe chicken, goat, recognizing their festival or festive period, those are the activities to maintain your cordial relationship with them and covenant with them. And the police must live according to the instructions in submission so that the power can continue to abide with him. And that is what children of God do not realize in this generation. Once you give your life to Christ, you think it's finished. And the next day you see a evil spirit, you want to cast it out. The reason why Jesus was able to cast out any evil spirit without sweating is obedient submission. Philippians chapter 2 from verse 5. I will close on that. Philippians 2, 5.
Philippians 2, 5.
Yes.
Let this mind be in you.
To 11, to 12, yes. No.
Which was also in Christ Jesus.
Look at what it says. It says, let this mind be in you. Which means, please understand this principle very well. And do not forget that it's very important. Yes.
Who being in the form of God.
He was created in the form of God.
Thought it not robbery to be equal with God.
He thought it not robbery to be equal. Which means, he did not consider himself in arrogance to be equal with God. Number two stage to be submitted, submissive to God, is humility. If you are not humble, you cannot cast any evil spirit out. Because they will not bow. Anyone that is not humble, no spirit can bow down for him too. Humility makes every spirit listen to you. That's why the Bible says in the book of James, chapter 4, verse 7, submit yourself to God and resist the devil and he will flee. Under submission to God, the number one stage is what?
Obedience.
Number two is what?
Humility.
Under submission, because we see a wife that says, what is it? We are the same. And the husband is saying, I'm the head of this, and the wife says, no. You might be the head, but we are equal. We are equal. That person is what? Not humble. So humility is another second point of submission. Number one is obedience. Number two is humility. Yes, continue reading, ma'am.
Verse 6 of Philippians 2.
Jesus did not overthrow God because he was called God. Because he was image of God and he had power like God. He did not overthrow God. That was why he was his name. You will find out now. Amen. Thank God for the Holy Spirit. He's all over you. He's moving you around. Move Philippians 2. We are in verse 6 now.
In the form of God.
Yes.
Thought it not robbery to be equal with God.
Uh-huh.
That made himself of no reputation.
Uh-huh.
And took upon him the form of a servant.
You see, he made himself of what? No reputation. He took upon him the form of what? A servant. Yes?
And was made in the likeness of man.
He was made in the likeness of man.
And be found in fashion as a man.
He was found in the fashion as a man.
He humbled himself.
He humbled himself.
And became obedient unto death.
You see those 2 points there? Humbled himself, became obedient unto death. Number three is?
And to death of the cross.
Amen. In the book of Isaiah, where he was talking about when he was dragged as a mighty man was dragged like a fool. Because he was what? He was gentle as a sheep. So number three is meekness. If I'm telling you the truth, I am not lying to you. If you have these three things in your life, you will speak from distance to evil spirit, they will hear you. You don't need to have to be sweating. Oh yeah, come on. Hey, come on. Oh yeah, come on. And you are sweating the whole place. You are sweating the evil spirit. No, I'm not coming out. Number one is what?
Obedience.
Number two is what?
Obedient.
Humility. And number three is what?
Meekness.
Everything is under submission. The genuine submission is when you see obedience, humility, and meekness. You see a man, you speak to his wife, say, okay. And you are quiet. Men, they like that kind of thing. They will now go to the corner and begin to smile. Yes, I exercise my franchise. When you want to see, they will squeeze face again. Uh-huh. What do you say? When you look at it, you know, they like when they have that authority and you are listening. They will not go and smile in the kitchen or in the bathroom. They will not come back with tough face again so that you don't know that they are cheating. Amen. Because some men cheat, some men actually cheat on that obedience. And you Amen. Praise the Lord. But the Lord is a true friend. He's never cheating on our obedience. He doesn't take our obedience, humility, and meekness for granted. He takes it as seriousness that these people, they truly love me. And that is symbol of love. Submission is your symbol of love to God. In obedience to his word, keeping his commandments, keeping his instruction and law, and humility, not taking yourself to be anything that you are not. Even if God has just used to raise a limb that they just walked, it's all glory be to the name of the Lord. Not making adverts from it. And give the glory to the name of the Lord. And meekness. Gentle. That's what we call gentle. Or gentility. Or whatever language they want to use to it. When you are calm, easygoing, gentle. A child of God is supposed not to be a too much talkative. You know, we have to be gentle. Hear more. The Bible says, the same book of James, you hear more and you speak little. You hear more and you speak little. And that little you speak, we have weight. They will never forget it in the hurry. It's just like, you know, when I see somebody, for instance, is talking, saying bad thing about me, and talking, I will look like this. And when I release one, that person might not be able to sleep. Only one, small. Because you turn your body, you turn this one, you turn the other one, only one, until that person come and say, I'm sorry about what I said yesterday. Because when you don't waste your word will carry weight. It will release things that will change a life, that will redeem a soul. So we must be obedient, we must be humble, and we must be meek. That is submission to God. Submission to God. Then we'll be able to resist the devil. And the devil will do what? You'll be able to resist the devil, and the devil will do what? We'll resist the devil, and the devil will do what? He has no choice than to flee. He has no choice than to flee. When you live in all these three things faithfully without deceiving yourself, your prayer has to be efficient immediately. I remember one day, Israel high. During the time he came to do holiday with us. All of a sudden, I don't know what happened to his eye. He was just doing like this. And the eyeball just got swollen. You remember the time? The two eyeballs just got swollen and it swelled up the two eye. I said, my God, what is this? Even my wife was even talking about maybe taking him to GP. What is this? I've never seen such thing. The two eye was just swollen. The eyeball came out here. Within few minutes, when it was just scratching the eyes. So I said, okay. It was in this place I called him. I said, come here. Just something that it is only God that can do that in a few minutes. Not human being. Even the medicine from the hospital cannot make that disappear immediately. They have to be putting the maybe eye drop for a few days for it. They will say, go and put a few days. According to the advert, if your sickness persists more than 3 days, consult your doctor. Ah, you didn't hear publicity for medicine. They used to put it on the sachet. If your symptom persists more than 3 days, consult your GP. So all of a sudden, but our GP is already in place. If we are obedient, we are humble, and we are meek. All of a sudden there, I just annoyed because I believe in the word of God says, if any of you is what? The book of James, seek. Go to the wood. The elders, and they will anoint him and pray. And the prayer of faith will do what?
We give you seed.
That is it. That's where anointing all comes in. for the people that don't believe, I know. He said that it will be anointed and prayed, and the prayer of faith will heal the sick. And anointed the two eyes and prayed, and he went inside. By the time he come outside, the eye was going down. There was changes immediately. And before we went home, it was gone. That same day from here. So we didn't need to take him to any JP anymore. So many things like that we can see, we can point to. I don't want to say many things. I don't like talking about miracles. But all I know is that I'm just saying this one too for us to know that you have stages where you can tell anything to hear your word, and they have to obey you. David says was in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 22, and the same thing in the Psalm 22 verse 18. He says, "The stranger obey me." Can you give me opportunity to read that one before I go? Please, can I read that one? Because I've finished. Amen. 1 Samuel 22. Is it 2 Samuel of? But it's in Psalm 18. But let's read it from, let's read it from 2 Samuel. It's also in 2 Samuel, the same thing. 2 Samuel 22.
2 Samuel. Second Samuel 22:45.
Mm-hmm.
Strangers shall submit themselves unto me.
Strangers shall submit. They shall submit themselves unto me.
As soon as they hear.
As soon as they hear.
They shall be obedient unto me.
They shall be obedient unto me.
Strangers shall fade away.
The strangers shall fade away.
And they shall be afraid out of their closed places.
And they shall be afraid out of their closed hidden places. Amen.
Amen.
So everything that is not of God in your life and home, they are what? Strangers. Because that is not their original home. Sickness is stranger to your body. Because the book of Jeremiah, from where God gave us a message on Friday prayer meeting, prayer night, in that Jeremiah chapter 30, he says, "I will restore health to your body." And he let us know in from verse 16 that it is sin that brings health problem, isn't it? Sin that brings sickness. So when it gets to that 16, can we open it? Jeremiah. I don't mean to read it. It's just because I forgot and I have to read it to you. Jeremiah 30.
Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 16. Verse 15. Why cry thou for thy affliction?
He said, why are you crying for your affliction?
That sorrow is incurable.
Your sorrow? Yes.
For the multitude of thy iniquity.
You see, sorrow and pain come from multitude of what? Sin. Yes.
Because thy sin we are increased, I have done these things unto thee.
So he said, because the sin was increasing, that the reason why the Lord brought sickness and pain. Now what happened in the next chapter verse?
Therefore, all they that devour thee shall be devoured.
Because he has now forgiven you. You have now turned from your wicked ways. You are now living under, you are not submitted to him. That's where another submission coming. Since you have submitted to God, remember that Psalm 91 says, He that dwelleth in the secret place of Most High shall abide under the shadow of Almighty. That is submission. Submission to the secret place of Most High will give you a shadow of Almighty around you. And since you are not submitted to God, what happened in 16, man? Everyone that devour you will be devoured.
Amen.
Because you are submitted. I'm telling you the truth, I am not lying. When you are submitted to God, your devourer will be devoured.
Amen.
Yes?
And all the adversaries, every one of them, shall go into captivity.
You see, all your enemies raising against you, they have no choice. When you are submitted to God, they will all go into captivity.
Amen. Yes.
Yes.
And they that spoil thee shall be a spoil.
You see, those, you know what they call spoiler? Those that are looting, looting your finances, looting your life, stealing illegally, all those cankerworm, caterpillar, and all those things, palmerworm and all that, stealing your finances, stealing your health, because you are not submitted to God. They will go into captivity in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes.
And all that pray upon thee will I give for a prey.
You see, pray. The meaning of prayer is that those that want to feed on your flesh, sickness that want to feed on your flesh, there is something they call cancer now. You know, because they don't know the name, they call it cancer. If you one day I was watching a documentary on cancer, and when they were showing all those affected parts of cancer, it showed to me that it was something, they don't know what it is, but it's just like something hitting some part of human body. It starts from small, it will be spreading as a wound, and something it will be hitting. And the medical science have not found that thing hitting in the body. They will hit until they hit the dangerous part and kill human being. And that is what this one is called. So cancer is also part of them that God is talking about, according to what I put there. So anything that has turned your body to pray, to eat, the Bible said they will become prey themselves. They will begin to eat and swallow themselves. In the mighty name of Jesus. Once you are submitted to God, Isaiah 49 in 25 of it says, they will do what? They will eat their own flesh. They will be drunken with their own blood, and they begin to eat their own flesh. Therefore, I confirm it and I reconfirm again that those that have turned your life and body and children to prey, they will become prey. They begin to eat themselves and drink their own blood. In the name of Jesus. Because you are submitted to God. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
The way you were reading, have you finished? I'm supposed to finish now. I need fast reader. We need to be sharing grace now. She was reading, she closed the Bible.
Because it's found another place. It said, therefore, those who devour you
shall be devoured.
All your adversaries, everyone
shall go into captivity.
Those who plunder you shall become plundered. And all who pray upon you
shall become prey.
For I will restore health to you.
I will do what?
I will restore health.
If you have been sick before, because the Bible says sin brings sickness. So now that you are submitted to God, He said your sickness will be abomination to your body.
Amen.
I will restore health to your body.
Amen.
Part of the heritage of children of God and those that are submitted to God is good health.
Amen.
That is why you see a submitted man of God will grow old until they do like this. They will tell them, Baba, you need to go home. He said, don't worry, I will sleep after Sunday morning. On Sunday after church, I will sleep and go home. Don't worry. They will tell you when they will go. When you are submitted, you determine when you go. That's the secret some people don't know. If there is anything you must do, seek to be submitted to God. Seek to do His will in obedience, in humility, in meekness. You will control your word. You will speak to things that you want. You will call things that are not as if though they were. And you take territories and you take over your enemies, the camp of your enemy.
Yeah.
He says, I will restore health back to you. Yes?
And heal you of your wound, says the Lord.
Every wound that you have been carrying since you were born. I'm not talking about physical wound. People that were raped is wound. People that were one thing or the other happened to you, you know, the kind of business or things you did in life that you are not supposed to do that you are still regretting up to now. Those are open wounds. The Lord says, I will heal your wound. Those words that they are speaking about your life that people used to insult you, Baron, this one or that one, those are the wounds. The Lord will heal your wound. Maybe you are the one that says, oh, you see, she can never marry. She can never have children. Oh, she can never. Then once you are submitted, the Lord begins to heal your wound. He begins to provide what you need. What people have tagged you with, they have placed tag and plate number upon your name for that reason. The Lord will heal your wound. What thing, people think it's impossible concerning your life, your destiny, your marital life, your health, your situation. In as much as you abide, you submit yourself to God. I tell you the truth, I'm not lying. The Lord will heal your womb. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes?
Because they called you an outcast.
You see, because they call you an outcast, they have written off your life. They think nothing can come out of your life. Nobody wants to speak to you. Nobody wants to come your way. Nobody wants to be associated with you. They don't want to be known with you because they think you are low life, no value. But the Lord is saying to you, inasmuch as you submit yourself, you will resist loneliness. You will resist all that kind of name or tag that they have placed upon you. They call you outcast, but the Lord will put value upon your name. He will build tents around your life, beauty around your life. People that have called you for second, they will look for you for advice, for counseling, for instruction, because they will see the hand of God upon your life in this season by the power that rose Jesus from the dead. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You shall no longer be time forsaken.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord will brought. He will bring to you the beauty that will make those who that have run away from you to come to you.
Amen.
Because human beings are like that. When they see you in fulfillment, they will run to you.
Amen.
Because you now have what they want. Before you didn't have what they want. But what man need in this generation that will make men run to you? The Lord will place it in your life.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You become a problem solver to your generation.
Amen.
You will not become a burden to your generation.
Amen.
You will become a problem solver in your generation.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Only submit yourself to God.
Amen.
And you resist the devil.
Amen.
Submit yourself to God. Can you finish it, man? That passage.
This is Zion.
This is Zion.
No one will seek her.
You are the Lord Zion. You are no longer forsaken. Your life is no longer barren. Because the Bible says your life will now be called Beulah. No longer barren. Amen. You shall no longer be time forsaken. You are no longer an outcast that stay on alone, live alone, eat alone, sleep alone. Inasmuch as you start today to begin to search, how can I live submit to God? Submission to God is when God decides everything around your life. It's your husband. You imagine that God, submission to husband is like submission to God. He has to decide my life. He has to decide my step. He needs to lead me. He needs to instruct me. He needs to teach me. I need to tell him where I go. I need to tell him what I do. I need to tell him where I move to. That's the way. Isn't that the way we deal with our husband? You tell your husband where you go, isn't it? You tell your husband what you do, isn't it? You tell him, you take permission of everything. That is the way you need to do with God. Permission with God, permission for traveling, permission for going anywhere, listening to instructions and obeying is leading. And you see him working for you. Amen. And I will close on this song. My God is a miracle God. My God is a miracle God. My God is a miracle God.